Listening Library presents Horrible Harry Cracks the Code by Suzy Kline. Read for you by Joshua Swanson.
The Ketchup War. My name is Doug, and I'm in third grade. I write stories about my best friend Harry. He's the guy who loves slimy things, creepy things, and horrible things. He's also the guy who loves being a detective. He sure messed up his last case, though. Mary was talking about it at noontime. We were all eating lunch at room 3B's cafeteria table. "Harry, I can't believe you thought Miss Mackle was engaged to the music teacher," she groaned. "You were so sure it was Mr. Marks. Some detective you are." Harry stuffed an orange wedge in his mouth and flashed Mary a jack-o'-lantern smile. "Arr! Arr! Arr!" he mumbled. Song Lee giggled. Mary ignored Harry. She gently pressed her packet of ketchup 4 times to make tiny red dots on her hot dog. When Sydney squeezed his packet of ketchup, it squirted all over the place. A few drops even landed on Song Lee's pretty white sweater. The pansy on her sleeve was not purple and yellow anymore. It was red. Harry immediately took out his orange wedge and dropped it on his blue lunch tray. "Hey, Sid, you got ketchup on Song Lee's sweater. How about saying you're sorry?"
"But it's not my fault," Sid whined. "I can't help it if my ketchup packet doesn't work right."
Song Lee used her spork to scrape off the ketchup. When she finished, we could see a big pink smudge on her sleeve.
"Oh no, your favorite sweater is ruined," Mary groaned.
Harry ripped open one corner of his ketchup packet, leaned toward Sydney, and squeezed it with one mighty push.
Whoosh! Kersplat!
Ketchup landed on Sydney's face.
"Ew-ee," Ida said. "Sydney has a bloody nose."
"And bloody teeth," Mary added.
"But it's not my fault," Harry replied. "I can't help it if my ketchup packet doesn't work right."
Those were the exact words Sid used. When Sydney wiped his face with a napkin, he missed some ketchup under his nose. It looked like he had a red mustache.
"Very funny, Harry the Canary," Sid growled. "Only I forgot to laugh."
"You'd better not forget to apologize to Song Lee," Harry said. "Or else."
"Or else what?" Sid demanded.
"Or else it's a ketchup war," Harry said. "Between you and me."
"Bring it on, El Tweedo."
"After you, Sid the Squid."
Both boys reached for a ketchup packet. Both ripped off one corner.
We all leaned back and got out of the way.
"Fire one,"
Sid said, aiming the packet at Harry's face.
Whoosh!
Harry quickly bowed in prayer. The ketchup plopped on top of Harry's head. It blended in well with his red hair.
"Fire two,"
Harry said as he bobbed up, leaned forward, and squeezed his packet hard at Sid. Ketchup sprayed along the table. Most of it landed on Sid's cheek and chin. Harry ran his fingers through his hair.
"Ketchup gel is cool, Sid. Thanks for my new do."
Sidney grabbed his napkin and wiped his face again. He wasn't smiling like Harry. Slowly, he turned and looked at Song Lee.
"I'm sorry I got ketchup on you," he said. "I don't like it on me either."
"It was an accident," Song Lee replied with a forgiving smile. "It's okay, Sidney."
"The ketchup war is over," Harry sang out.
"I'm telling on you boys," Mary said, raising her hand in the air. "Mrs. Doshi."
The lunch aide came running over to our table.
"What's going on here?" she said.
"A ketchup war," Mary tattled.
"Harry Spooger and Sidney LaFleur are not using their ketchup packets properly, and Song Lee's sweater is stained." Mrs. Doshi asked the 3 ketchup victims to follow her. Several minutes later, they came back. Song Lee's sleeve was wet, but you could see the purple and yellow pansy.
The ketchup was rinsed out. Sid's face was clean and shiny. Harry's hair was wet and combed. Everyone watched Mrs. Doshi walk over to the portable blackboard. She wrote two names in white chalk. Harry Spooger, Sidney Lafleur. When she returned to our table, she handed Harry and Sidney each a wet sponge. "You two will wash all the cafeteria tables and all the chairs during lunch recess. The bucket is in the corner." Then she added, "There will be no ketchup packets allowed at this table for the rest of the week. If you want ketchup, I'll give you some from a large bottle." Harry glared at Mary.
"You just cost me a kickball game at noontime."
"Thanks a lot, Mary." "Yeah," Sid groaned. "Thanks a lot." Mary blew up her bangs. "Well, thanks to you, we won't have ketchup packets this week." Harry gritted his teeth.
"Listen to me, Tattletale. We could have cleaned up the mess ourselves. Tattle on me one more time, Mare, and I'll tattle on you."
Mary snickered. "That could never happen, Harry Spooger," she said. "I always follow the rules." Always, I thought. It was just a matter of time. The biggest case ever in room 3B. The next morning, when we were hanging up our jackets in room 3B, Harry had a bag under his arm.
"Okay, guys, I know why I goofed up my last case," he said.
Mary hung up her wool scarf. "I do, too. You're a horrible detective." Harry opened his bag.
"Nope, I just forgot to wear my detective hat."
"Detective hat? There's no such thing," Mary scoffed.
"Oh, yes, there is," Harry replied. "Haven't you ever heard of Sherlock Holmes? He's the world's greatest detective. He wore a special kind of hat when he was trying to solve a case."
"That's true," Zuzu said. "I've seen pictures of Sherlock Holmes in a book. He is a famous character in lots of detective stories by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. He wears a deerstalker hat. My dad tells me about some of his adventures."
"Cool,"
Harry said. Then he reached into a brown bag and pulled out a baseball cap.
"I'm about to show you my deerstalker hat. When I get it on, I'll be ready to investigate."
Mary rolled her eyes. "I think you'll be ready for baseball."
"I'm not done yet," Harry snapped.
We watched him reach into his bag again and take out a second baseball cap. He put the second one on top of the first so the visor was facing in the other direction. Zuzu nodded slowly.
"You know, Harry, that kind of looks like a deerstalker hat now."
"It will be good for shade," Song Lee added. Ida and Mary snickered and giggled. Dexter and Sidney shook their heads.
"So what are you investigating, Harry?"
Zuzu asked. Harry took off both caps and hung them on a hook.
"Well, that's the problem, Zoo. I don't have a case yet, but when I do, I'll be ready."
"Oh, boy," I thought. "I hope it's an easy one." I didn't want Harry to botch up two cases in a row. His reputation as a detective was on the line. As soon as we said the pledge and heard the morning announcements, we got a surprise visitor.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.